Now, we will study the characteristics of rate constant. To study the characteristics of rate constant, we will consider one of the general reaction A gives us to product. Okay. So, for this reaction, according to law of mass action, the rate expression can be written like this. Rate is equal to K into concentration of E or concentration of A power some X value, where X is called the order of the reaction. So, rate of a reaction is equal to K into concentration of A, where K is nothing but the rate constant. So, to define this rate constant, we will consider the concentration of reactant as 1. If the concentration of the reactants becomes equal to 1, then the rate of a reaction will be equal to the rate constant. Okay, so based on this relation obtained after taking the concentration of reactant as unity, so we can express the definition of the rate constant. So how can we define rate constant? Rate constant can be defined as the rate of reaction when the concentration of reactant becomes unity or 1. So that is called rate constant. Now we will study the characteristics. Characteristics of a rate constant. So, what are the characteristics of rate constant? So, we are going to study three different characteristics of rate constant. The first one is, as the rate constant increases, the value of rate of a reaction also gets increased. That means, higher the value of rate constant, more will be the rate of reaction. So, these two are directly related with one another. As the value of K increases, the value of rate of reaction also gets increased. That is the first characteristic. Next, the second characteristic is, the rate constant K depends on temperature. The rate constant K depends on temperature. In what way these two are related with one another? That means, as the temperature increases, the value of rate constant also gets increased. That means, the rate constant and temperature are directly related with one another. That is the second characteristic. And then, the rate constant, the third characteristic is, this rate constant is independent of concentration of reactants, and also the time interval. That means whether the reaction at the beginning or at the middle or at the end. So, for different intervals of time, the value of rate constant remains the same. And also, if the concentration of reactant is high or low or medium, the value of rate constant always remains same. So, these are nothing but the three different characteristics of rate constant. Next, we will, in the PUC, we have studied the derivation of rate constant for a zero order reaction and also first order reaction. So, we have studied the derivation of the rate constant expressions, integral form of rate expression for a zero order reaction and also first order reaction. So, we don't want these two, and we will go for the derivation of rate constant for a second order reaction. So, we will study the derivation of rate constant for a second order reaction. So, how can we derive the rate constant for a second order reaction? That we will study now. Okay. So, first we will consider one of the chemical reaction A plus B gives us to product. A plus B gives us to product. So, this chemical reaction is nothing but one of the reaction whose order is equal to 2. That means it is a second order reaction. So, how can we write the rate expression for a second order reaction for this equation? That is, dx by dt is equal to K into concentration of reactant A into concentration of reactant B. dx by dt is equal to K into concentration of reactant A into concentration of reactant B. So initially, so A and B are the reactants, and the amount of reactant initially taken as small a for capital A, that means A is the reactant whose initial concentration is small a, and B is nothing but the initial concentration of the reactant B. So after some time t, let x be the amount of reactants A and B consumed in the reaction. So if the amount of reactant A and B consumed in the reaction is found to be x, then the amount of the reactants A and B left over at time t, after time t, can be represented as A minus x for A, and for the reactant B it is called B minus x. So why it is called so? Because small a is the initial concentration of reactant A and small b is the initial concentration of reactant B, and x be the amount of reactant converted into product after time t. Okay, so after time t, the amount of reactants A and B left over is found to be, for reactant A it is found to be A minus x, and for reactant B it is B minus x. Okay, so after time t, we can represent the rate of a reaction in this form. That is, dx by dt is equal to K into concentration of A left over at after time t is found to be A minus x, that is A minus x, into the amount of reactant B left over after time t is found to be B minus x. So this is nothing but the rate expression. This is nothing but the differential form of rate expression for a second order reaction. Now we will go through the derivation of the rate expression for a second order reaction, which is nothing but the integral form of rate expression. Integral form of rate expression for a second order reaction. So for that, we will consider this equation, that is dx by dt is equal to K into concentration of A minus x into concentration of B minus x. So to derive the integral form of rate expression for a second order reaction, we need to take two different conditions. The first condition, when the concentration of reactant A, small a, becomes equal to small b. So this is nothing but the initial concentration of reactant A, and this is the initial concentration of reactant B. If both are same, that is one condition. The another condition is nothing but A not equal to B. So to derive the integral form of rate expression for a second order reaction, we will go for the first condition. So when small a becomes equal to small b, so if both the reactants are having same concentration, then the above expression can be taken as dx by dt is equal to K into concentration of A minus x into concentration of A minus x. Okay, so what will happen? Dx by dt is equal to K into concentration of A minus x whole square. So to get the integral form of rate expression, we will arrange this equation in such a way that dx by dt divided by A minus x. That means we will take the x terms towards one side and the other terms towards other side. That is K into dt. So and we will take the integration. We will apply the integrations on either side. So we have taken or we have applied the integrations on either side. So what is the integration of dx divided by A minus x whole square? This is in the form of 1 by x square. Integration of 1 by x square. So 1 by x square can be taken as minus 1 by x. Minus 1 by x, that is minus 1 divided by A minus x. Okay. And the differentiation of this A is 0, which is nothing but a constant, and the differentiation of minus x can be taken as minus 1, and this minus 1 and this minus can be taken as plus, that is 1 divided by A minus x. Here it is minus sign, and here also there is minus sign, minus into minus plus. And k is called the rate constant, which remains the constant value, and integration of dt can be taken as t. So we are doing the integration so that we have to introduce one of the constant called integration constant. That is 1 divided by a minus x is equal to kt plus I. I is called the integration constant whose value is to be determined. So to calculate the value of this integration constant, we will go for the initial condition. That is, when t is equal to 0, then the value of x also becomes equal to 0. Okay, so apply these two conditions in this equation, we get 1 divided by a is equal to k into 0, 0 plus I. The value of I is found to be 1 divided by A. So substitute the value of this I in this equation. 1 divided by A minus X is equal to KT in plus 1 by A, which implies KT is equal to, so if this moves to the left side, same kind of terms, 1 divided by A minus X minus 1 by A. So we will take the LCM for these two, so that KT is equal to A into A minus X. In the numerator, this A minus X cancels with this A minus X, so that only the value of A is left over, A minus, this AA gets cancels with one another, and the leftover is A minus X, plus into minus minus A, minus into minus plus X. Minus a plus a cancel with one another, so that the value of x at the numerator and a into a minus x in the denominator. Finally, what we got is k is equal to 1 over t into x divided by a into a minus x. So this is nothing but the integral form of rate expression for a second order reaction under the condition, that is a is equal to small a is equal to small b. If the initial concentration of both the reactants are having the same value, then we are going to write the integral form of rate expression for a second order reaction in this way. So this is the integral form of rate expression obtained when the concentration of both the reactants becomes equal, that is k is equal to 1 over t into x divided by A into A minus X.